Welcome back, everybody. This is Heaven's Army playing Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. Didn't know how noisy it was in here. My goodness. Anyway, I have a plan. And I figured if I could never figure out Juhani. And yes, I found my piece of papers. I don't know why I looked to the left with the camera on the game instead of me looking left. I found more than four pieces of paper of Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. It was in the back of the binder with my PlayStation 4 stuff, so no wonder I couldn't find it before. But yeah, I didn't have any Juhani stuff. So that means, based on those facts, that if I have never figured out Juhani, it's because I've never leveled her up. And then talked to her before I moved on to places. And what I need to do is bring her with me. Now, I was saving up my points for stealth, but you know what? Let's bring up my treat injury so that I could heal her when I need to. Then she get major heals. And I'm going to bring up her HP first, giving her plus one more vitality and one, and an additional vitality. Yeah, perfect. Powers. I've learned, not that this is an amazing thing, but ability to cancel the first and second tier force powers active on the target. So if you click on a target and they have, like, one of these things, you can remove it. But, that's, like, all, like, the Jedi stuff. I'm basically fighting Sith, so I guess I'm not gonna really use that. But, yeah, I think I want, like, stuff for my party and other stuff for my party. And then I'll work on the whirlwinds and stuff too with Juhani. Not that she's gonna be like my all-time endgame character, but I might as well. I only have one of those. All right, well, I'll catch up in no time. Powers. Ooh, do I want that or that? That. I'm gonna level up Juhani all the ways, and have her walk around with me. Awareness. Treat injury. Powers. Now she can learn her either stasis. She doesn't have dark side powers. So whirlwind it is. I mean, you can still use dark side powers, but she's pretty far up on the grid. It'll take all of her force points to cast one of them things. One of the dark side powers. And with light side powers, then yeah, you can use a lot less. It's just like it's a waving thing. If you use light side stuff, it's going to cost less points. That's all I wanted to say. Charisma. High charisma adds modifiers to force related feats and powers that are very important to all the Jedi classes. It's also essential to any persuasive talker, but she's pretty even now. I'll take that. Skills, that and that. Sorry, I started the episode off in the middle of Force, Master Jump, ooh, and Master Sense. And there's another thing. When I was leveling up, I was fooling around with everything. It gives your character a plus 3 defense to all blaster bolt deflection rolls. So if anyone fires at you, they'll really never hit you. And then you get like a plus 6, and then I don't think like almost like anything that gets shot at you, you bounce it back. Like, it's amazing. But I wasn't really focusing on stuff like that. Not yet, anyway. I would rather her to get all of her, make her stats go like 10, 11, and 7, and even go even higher. And she's got her cure now. I may need that. Yeah, now she's 15, 3, 13, and 12. That's awesome. That's so many, such awesome rolls she's going to have. Anyway, my bad for like a level up menu screen, but I figure I might as well get this done. There, now she's got a plus 3 to everything. What else can she learn? Okay, let's let her learn the defense thing first for the party. Sure. There, now she's done. Wow, look at the stats. And she's pretty awesome there, too. Anyway, okay, so that's Juhani level up. And I'm going to level up Candorous, too. I really wasn't planning on doing that, but now I guess I am. Demolitions is Candorous. Oh, really? Feats or... He's done. And his gun is done. Alright, that's awesome. More better rolls, then. Because I think it has to do with leveling up now. Well, at least that's what I think. Anyway, oh, I gotta get him. Okay, there you go. There you go. He's like, he's gonna be conditioned to the max. And now he's demolitions. So now I'm at that point where he doesn't need melee, and he doesn't need any of these guns. I could power up his a minus three penalty. I could power up his, like, I think I made him learn, like, all the gun stuff before, which was awesome. He killed so many things. Repair, security, and computer. That must be your... No. Their demolitions is there. I might as well make him start learning demolition stuff. Why not? More levels? I'll do it. I might as well just do it all. There, dexterity. One more plus modifier to his guns. He's going to be insanely awesome. And that's 9 plus whatever I learned with the feats. So yeah, now it's 9 plus 2 skills to both demolitions, and plus 1 given to caution. Nice. More. Give me more. Give me all the levels. He's going to be able to hack, like, all the things. There you go. That's done. Cool. And I am going to go up one level. Just because I think I need to level up 2. But I don't know. Okay, I got that stuff. I got, health is done now. I'm behind too, I see. Okay, I want the whirlwind. that's enough. Alright, Juhani is not a warp off the ship and walk out. Juhani is, I think, walking around after you get to find out more story about her. So, and if Candorous works, then I know Candorous is also to do with levels.
Yeah, what do you want?
What are your thoughts now?
This thing with Joggy, is there some...
Okay, and I do need probably more time. I just leveled them up. And what I did before was I warped around. Juhani, I made Juhani's story kick in, but I leveled up a bunch of times.
What is it you would like to speak to me about?
Oh, there you go. We got it now. Tell me more about your past.
I mentioned before that my parents had fled to Taris. Perhaps I can tell you about that.
Yeah, please do.
In the early days of the Mandalorian War, there had been fighting closer to the Outer Rim worlds.
Right. Near the world your species comes
Cathar
from?
Was there, yes. My people had a great reputation as warriors, and that appealed to the Mandalore version of honor. They sought to test themselves against us, I think.
They did.
Test themselves by bombing our world, slaughtering my people while they slept or while they ran.
How did it happen?
They swooped down from space, across the world, firing at anything that moved. They used ships in space to destroy all orbital facilities and bombard the surface. We did resist. And in spite of their violent attack, we did stave them off for quite a while. But in the end, we were doomed.
I know why the Republic did not help them. Why did the Republic not help you? Because they stayed far enough away from the Outer Rims and only picked a few places. Candor's already told us about this.
We were not members of the Republic. Cathar was beyond the edge of the Republic and the Outer Rim. And besides, they could not have known. Our interstellar communications were the first things the Mandalores hit. All other short-range communicators were jammed. We were on our own. We knew what was coming. We had fought the Mandalorians in the first war against Exar Kun and the Sith. We knew there would be no mercy for us. The most we could do was pack the few of our people who survived onto what few ships remained and send them off into space as fast as they could. Most did not make it.
But you survived?
My parents carried me as a baby with them and were lucky enough to escape. They fled as far as they were able and eventually settled on Taris. They could stand running no further, I think. But Taris was a horrible choice. Dominated by humans, intolerant of other species, it made everyday life unnecessarily hard.
Yeah, they went from another... out of the frying pan and into the freezer. How did your family cope?
My father turned to stimulants. He spent much of his time in local bars and dives. But we are warriors. It runs through our blood. And when he was on stims, he became foolish. He let his warrior nature get the best of him, so he would get intoxicated, and he would fight. And finally, one day, he would die.
He died?
By a man who provoked him into a fight and killed him like an animal. I am sorry. I cannot talk about this any longer right now.
Oh, Juhani, she had such a hard past, too. And I think if we had Candorous and Juhani in the party, they'd probably will bicker about the past, actually, I think.
How may I be of assistance to you, Padawan?
Are you ready to talk more?
What is it you would like to speak to me about? Of course.
Oh, maybe I need to level up again. I don't really want to level up, though. I need all my levels for a couple boss fights. That I really need to, get that. I would love to have the chips going. The implants, sorry. brain chip, I guess. Anyway, the implants. And what else would I want? And I want my lightsaber thing. Oh, man. And then I want to choose between one-handed or dual-wielding at the top. And I don't know what I want. Powers. Defense. Whirlwind. Yeah, why not? Accept. Go.
How may I be of assistance to you, Padawan?
Am I on to something? I was wondering
what
if we could talk.
What would like to speak to me about?
I have to level up too. So that's why you never got Juhani done. What happened after your father died?
My father died. My mother was left to support me alone. A single non-human woman living in one of the worst, most violent slums on Terrace. It was not easy for her.
How
when
so?
When my father was killed, it seemed that something in her began to die as well. She worked. She worked as hard as she was able. But over time, she began to waste away. I later learned that she was unable to get enough money to feed both of us, and had to start borrowing from the exchange. Cutthroats and smugglers. But even that was not enough. She hid what she was doing from me. She gave most of her food to me so that I would be strong, but she herself was suffering deeply from it. In the end, she could go on no longer and collapsed at the cantina where she worked one day.
What did you do for her?
She never recovered. There was nothing really that I could do for her. She left me no money, and no doctor would see her without being paid first. I sat by her bed for days as she lay there dying. I never want that to happen to someone I care about ever again. But there was still the money she had borrowed. She had never paid it back and made no provisions for her death. You must understand, the exchange is brutal. They care nothing for the life of a sentient being. They are the major suppliers of slaves on Terrace.
I killed Davik, so you know what? That's fine. And so did the Sith, technically. They captured you? You were enslaved. They captured
they
you.
I thought it would be appropriate that, with my mother owing them money, the debt should be passed on to me. And with no way to pay, they took me by force. You have no idea what it is like to be bound like a beast and treated as such. It was the worst time of my life. They treated me like livestock. They were waiting for a buyer to give them some credits for me when the Jedi came to fight the Mandalorians.
And they freed you.
The Jedi could not abide by what they saw there and drove the exchange from the face of the world, freeing those of us imprisoned there. But the Jedi soon left to fight their war, and I was left with a dream.
What did you do? The exchange was there. They drove the exchange away and then Davik came by. Oh, who works for the exchange? Oh, what did
I
you do?
That I would become a Jedi. As soon as I had enough money to do it, I bought passage on a freighter headed for Dantooine. And we both know what has happened since then.
You became a Jedi.
I am grateful to you for having given me the opportunity to fulfill my dream, rather than become what I hated. Someday, I may make it up to you. But for now, let us keep on the task at hand.
Focus on the task at hand? Juhani, you too?
I may be of assistance to you.
I was wondering if you could talk.
Of course.
I gotta level up again? Oh my goodness, I am not gonna be able to make it. I'm gonna have to, like, eat all of the all of the med packs I have. Oh no, I'm like completely even. Do I need more health so that I never die? That's a lie. More dexterity, which gives me some defense, and adds modifiers for ranged attack rolls, but it gives me defense, making me harder to hit. Or strength, which allows me to hit harder and gives me chances to hit with vibro blades and lightsabers, which is what I focus on. Eventually, I'm going to get like a plus 5 or plus some really high number strength if I want to buy that and make my strength out of this world strong. Or I could focus on some more like charisma stuff and then try to get some force related. I need force. I think I might soon start learning the force persuade thing. But yeah, I don't think I need that. Let's go. I don't know what strength or dexterity. Dexterity, strength and then dexterity. That'd be lovely. Skills. Just that, I guess. And powers. I got cure now. Because I was going to learn this. Extra options open up in conversation. Ah, no. See, I should have learned that beforehand. Juhani, let's see if... to you, Padawan? Let's see if this is good. What is it you would... Yeah, there you go. So each level I get unlocks her next conversation. Oh.
I have told you my life story already. What more could you possibly want to know? Well, there is one thing. I did not want to mention it before, because I was unsure how you would react.
What is it?
Do you remember when I told you of the Jedi who had come to my world to fight the Mandalorians? They were recruiting soldiers for their crusade against the Mandalores. Many people joined them.
Yes, you mentioned
the
this.
The main reason for that was their charismatic leader, the one whose troops freed me and let me dream of seeking out and joining the Jedi Order. I was hesitant to talk to you about this because, well...
Well, what?
The Jedi had come to fight the Mandalores under the leadership of a powerful young Jedi, a Jedi named Revan.
Revan? You mean
Revan? The
what?
Jedi who turned to the dark side, became the Dark Lord of the Sith, and was defeated by Bastila and her strike team. I do not know what happened in the wars with the Mandalorians that turned Revan and Malak, or what they sought with these star maps, but the Jedi I knew was a paragon of the Order. I'm sorry if this seems wrong to you, but to understand, you must realize that Revan was as great as a Jedi could be. Whatever turned Revan must be terrible indeed. I wonder if what we find at the end of our journey will turn us as well.
I shall never fall like Revan did.
This is meaningless speculation, I guess. I just wanted you to know what I held from you. But rest assured that I will not hold back. If our enemy is Malak, Revan's apprentice, or indeed, even if it was Revan, I will help you through all trouble. Such is the will of the Council, and my own.
Ooh, Juhani. I think I made it to that point now. Juhani has revealed that it was Revan's army that freed her. Maybe she will tell you more in time. What? Really? Oh, there's not another one. I don't know.
How may I be of assistance to you?
I think I leveled up.
Of course.
I think I leveled up a whole bunch, and that's as far as I made it last time. And I thought Juhani just needed to be talking about her mom, which she did. So I think we're good. Candorous, are you also a part of the level? Because Juhani just Juhani's conversation opened up as I leveled.
Yeah. What do you want?
You
this
talk.
Thing with Joggy, is there some-
You don't need any more time. Duh, anyway. So, I think I'm ready for Korriban. I think Juhani's is you just gotta run around with her in your party after you have these conversations with her. And now that I'm leveled up and she's leveled up, it's probably going to happen now. Let's do it. Korriban. Yeah, go. I'm assuming we're gonna be fighting things this time? No! The last time I warped out here, I had to fight my way out. The live stream is just like, nah, you don't need to fight. Oh, another vision, right. I went back to Dantooine, though, and then came back to Tatooine. And it didn't work that way, so hers is definitely having her in your party. And being high enough level. That looks like it's definitely underground. Oh, the music. What do I do when I'm a Jedi here? She takes. There you go.
The Force continues to work through us, showing us the star maps unearthed by Revan and Malak. There are some who believe Korriban is the birthplace of the Sith. This planet is an evil place. There are secrets here best left uncovered.
It looked like the star map was in some sort of cave.
During the vision, I felt cold and trapped, almost as if I was buried alive. It felt like we were in some kind of tomb. No doubt things will become more clear once we discover the star map's location.
Won't the Sith recognize you?
Maybe you're right. Most of the Dark Jedi would only know me by name, but there are a few among them who might recognize my face. For the safety of our mission, I must remain on the Ebon Hawk while we are on this planet.
Well, that sucks. No Bastila. That's alright. I got Juhani leveled up and Candorous, but Carth is coming with me, so...
How can I help?
Visions, Gizga, never mind.
We move on.
So I think Bastila is done to the point. We're on Korriban, by the way. Talk
about what? I'll understand if we can't.
We're here, Carth. Yeah, Carth Onassi. We are here on Korriban. Johnny.
How may I be of assistance? What is
talk?
Of course.
Perhaps later, and she doesn't do the thing. What planet we're on? Do you know Wooks? Wooks. Zalbar? planet we're on? I don't know much about the planets we visit, but I suppose I should learn. When you ask someone else, I will listen as well. Problem? Unless you want someone threatened or door bashed in, you should ask someone else. Alright, we'll talk later. Alright, that didn't go well. You...
Got something on your mind, dude?
Do you have any more stories? You mentioned something about your wife earlier.
Before. To talk about.
I don't mean to pry, but...
Yes, you do. You may mean well enough, but my private affairs are just that. Private. Let me tell you something.
Oh?
Once you've lived as many years as I have, you'll have yourself a long, long list of memories. If you're lucky, most of them will be good. If you're not, some will be bad. If you're really unlucky, some will be so bad you'll never want to be reminded of them again, ever. You'll go far away. To a place that doesn't hold any memories at all. And there you'll be happy just to forget and be forgotten.
But you left. No, I want to hear what you have to say. Is that why you went to Kashyyyk?
Partly, maybe. I doubt I could ever explain it to you fully, even if I wanted to. Let me ask you this. Have you ever been in love? Truly in love, I mean, and not simple infatuation.
Well...
Exactly. You're still at the beginning of your life. There will be women in your life. Perhaps many women. But if you're fortunate, you'll find love once. The Jedi, with their damnable sense of overcaution, would tell you love is something to avoid. Thankfully, anyone who's even partially alive knows that's not true.
Well, here we go. We're on to something. Finally, what's this? Love advice from an old Jedi? You aren't worried about the dark side at all? No, you know what? That's what I've always thought.
Love doesn't lead to the dark side. Passion can lead to rage and fear and can be controlled. But passion is not the same thing as love. controlling Agreed. Your passions while being in love, that's what they should teach you to beware. But love itself will save you, not condemn you.
Right.
Listen to me go on as if I had all the answers.
What but you're
do
right.
I know of love anymore? I'm just a lonely old man who's not even a Jedi.
Sounds like love is something you should have avoided. Ooh, no. You talk too much, old man. You don't know anything. No, I want to hear what you have to say. Not even a Jedi. You mean not anymore, right? No. No, I want to hear what you have to say.
Do you? I wouldn't listen too closely. I'm no authority on anything. I just think that the greatest things in life shouldn't be avoided because they come with a few complications. Love causes pain, certainly. Inevitably, love is going to lead to as much sorrow and regret as it does joy. I suppose there are perfect eternal loves out there, but I haven't seen any. And how do you deal with the bad part of love is what determines your character. What determines the dark side's hold over you.
Whoa! Whoa, we're like bringing in love with Star Wars stuff? That's so cool. Okay. I want more of this. You don't think love can work? Maybe the Jedi just think you shouldn't take that risk. Oh. So what happens between you and your wife then? Oh my goodness. You know what? Maybe the Jedi think you shouldn't take that risk. Because, yeah, it's good, but it's like a double-edged sword, but I don't know. It's still not love's fault. Right. See, I missed the Valentine's Day thing. Darn you game for not working. But it's not love's fault.
Life without risk is boring. Is that how you want to live? You want love? You've got to fight for it. I'll tell you one thing. Sometimes, no matter how hard you try, you and the one you love simply aren't meant to be together. The trick is to know when that is, to know when it's time to fight and when it's time to part ways. There I go, waxing philosophical again. Somebody blast me already. Let's get going before I start talking in riddles, damn it.
Wow! Hey, Jolie Bindo. Talking about love in the Star Wars space kind of way. I like it. Anyway, talked a little about his wife. I didn't really force the wife conversation to happen because I just wanted to know. I need more wisdom, old man. Anything about this place?
Korriban's a rock. Mind the Sith. And that's about all I got to say about that. Now, let's get going.
Korriban is a rock. Mind the Sith. No, we need to hear that again. Tell me the thing on... Anyway, never mind. Alright, fine, we're leaving. That was awesome! My goodness, I've learned so much from video games. You...
Statement.
Restore, master, symbol, HK... That'll be all, HK.
Master.
Signing off.
Yeah, what do you want?
Thoughts?
This thing with, is there...
Planet?
Korriban is a Sith world, that's for sure. I mean, just look at this place. Rumor has it that the leader of our clan at the time, Mandalore, did go down. They say the Sith performed terrible magics here. Do you have anything else you want to ask?
Mandalore went down and saw the Sith and they allowed him down in there? Was Mandalore a Sith as well? Wouldn't that be something? I don't even know now. Mission... What are we gonna do with
hey
you?
There. What can I do for you?
Your bro.
I don't know anything about Korriban, but I get a bad
misclick.
Feeling in this place. If there's such a thing as an evil planet, this is it. Sorry,
I
can't
misclicked.
Help.
That's great. Your brother, I clicked on the wrong
I've
thing.
I've made my peace with Griff. So is it?
Okay. No. Okay, that's good. Let's go, cause I talked to everyone except Juhani. Juhani, give me your story thing.
How may I be?
Bad talk.
Of course.
Nothing. Of course not. Alright, let's go. So I'm gonna bring Juhani and Carth. And I'm gonna level up Carth, maybe. Who has the guns that... Oh no, I gotta bring Juhani because I need her conversation to kick in. Something needs to happen. And Candorous just needs time for some reason. A lot more time than I remember. The most amount of time. Alright, party. Can I change my party now? Yes, I can. You know what? Why did I do that? You... And... You wield the double guns, don't you? You have a heavy blaster. Oh, really? Okay, so I unequipped him. That's good. Medium, heavy. Computer and... computer. Basic and advanced. Sweet. Alright, just upgraded him a bunch. Awareness? Blaster pistol. Nope, you'll stay there. Nothing. Light. Light, medium. He's got a bowcaster equipped. 3 and 10. Nice. Oh, that's weak. Okay, done. Party. Sure. I thought he had my my pistol, but I guess not. Zalbar has his weapon. Jolie has that. And Candrus, you're already equipped with your stuff, right? I'm gonna finally get everyone equipped. Bendax. She has Bendax thing. Oh. Dang. Okay, let's get 3, 10, and 11. Chundar's bowcaster's awesome. Sith assassin pistol. They're both awesome. Okay. You're gonna have that. Kendris has his gun. The Chundar's bowcaster. It's way better than his, only because I think I... Did I upgrade that one? Oh, I don't even know. I probably didn't. Anyway, he gets to keep all of this that he has. Dexterity plus one. Yeah, he could have it. All right, good. Wrong button. Whoops. Party. My actual party now. I'm going with... you and you. Okay. Checking your guns. You need... Mandalorian. No. You're getting Bendax. And you got Bendax. Good. Reflex plus two. Fortitude, no. You get Wisdom plus five. I may need that. Awareness. Whatever. Will. Good enough. Doesn't need strength, but I'll give it to him anyway, because why not? He's got Kalo Nord's thing. Awesome! And you, Juhani. 3 and 17. She does have her thing upgraded. Okay, cool. Jedi. I may need to check my thing. What do I have on? Wisdom plus 5. Restriction not usable by Wookiees. I know that, but Wisdom plus 5, or Will plus 3, and Awareness plus 2. Whatever. I'll look cool wearing that, I guess. And Juhani has a thing I'm wearing. Cool, we're already good to go. Carth. What level are you? Level 7. Alright, why are you going up strength? Or intelligence, for that matter. You're gonna go up health. Demolitions, really? You know what, why not? Your health is probably done now. Accept, level up. Demolitions, why not? Feats. So health is done. His pistols are already done. If he goes up that, he could go up super rolls. And his dual wielding. Done. First. There you go. And now I can level you up again. Why not? My goodness, this is gonna be called a level up episode. If I go up his improved conditioning, it gives him super awesome rolls. Or, yeah, you know what, I might as well. Or I could give him this thing and start going up things for demolitions. But you know what? Let's give him a better chance of fighting. There you go, level 10. Level 13. Level 12. One more for good luck. He's done. Except, there we go, those are good stats.
Your wish?
What?
All right. I think I'm finally ready for Korriban. Oh, no, there's somebody waiting for me. Did that say Zerka? I think it did. My beautiful ship. There's nothing for me to open here, take. A mechanic. Hey, dude. What? I was just about to click on him and then something happened.
What the hell is your kind doing here? Bad enough I have to deal with all these other idiots, but now there's a stinking Cathar on this world, too?
I have as much right to be here as you do, sir.
I don't remember this. This never happened before. Do not seek to aggravate us. Just ignore him, Juhani. Just ignore him, Juhani.
Yeah, do like the Jedi tells you and back off. Your people are pathetic. There's no wonder we crushed your world so easily.
What? What do you know about my world?
I know enough that... Hey, wait a minute. You look familiar somehow.
What? You...
Do you know each other? Because this has never happened before. Oh my goodness, look at my... What? I may have to change my thing. I kind of like my red visor thing. Like Colossus or... Jody. Sure, I think that's his
this
name.
This doesn't concern you, Jedi trash. Now where could I have... No, he's dead and she likely is too.
What are you talking about?
Maybe
is that,
Still, I think a specimen like you would be a nice addition to my collection. So, what would it take, Jedi, for you to sell your pet here to me?
Dude, you are a jerk. Is that the guy who killed Jahani's father in the fight? She is not for sale. She is her own person. Well, what are you offering? Wow. She is her own person.
Now, don't be so selfish. We both know Cathar aren't real people anyway. The females are amusing pets, but the males should be put down like the animals they are. I remember one time on Taurus.
What?
This is bad.
What did you say?
You were on Taurus? Calm down, Juhani. Oh, frig. You were on... I would rather calm down, Juhani, or ask questions and let the thing go by. I'm glad I'm standing in the middle of them. What are you saying?
What did you do on Taurus, you scum?
Put one of you down like the animals you are. So easy. Then I saw one of the females on the auction block. But those darn Jedi.
It was you.
What? Me? Oh, now I recognize where I've seen that face before. You were the little Cathar I was going to. Those Jedi came and stole my pet away from me.
So I was right. And why is a Twi'lek or a Twi'lek evil? Usually they're not. What? Anyway, I'm learning too much. You were buying Cathar slaves?
I was fighting with the Mandalorians against the Cathar. I developed an appreciation for these creatures. They make excellent servants if properly trained. You Jedi act all prim and proper, but inside you must feel the same way I do about the lesser, non-human species. The Sith
what?
At least let their feelings show on the outside.
You. The whole world.
Come now. Will you let your pet go? I'm sure we can come up with a price we both think is fair.
She is not for sale. You'll only hurt her if I let her go. Show me the money first. She is not for sale.
And I will see you dead for what you have done to my people.
Hold on a second. Don't be hasty.
Do not fall to the dark side again, Juhani.
I will remain calm. I am a Jedi now. My lust for vengeance must be curbed.
Yes, yes. Say no to the dark side, but I will have you yet. Ha!
XOR. That never happened to me before, and I think it doesn't have to be Korriban. It could be Manon or any other planet as well. You just need to get her to that point. Oh, well, this is going to be my first time ever doing this on this game, because I never figured it out, and the only thing that makes sense is that I never leveled her up. And I never leveled up, and by the time I got through these planets, I was still a super low level.
Nice to see the Hawk still in one piece. Beauty of a ship, that.
The Hawk? We're playing Paper Mario again, are we? Leave Rock Hawk out of this. How do you know that, Ben Hawk? It probably goes here all the time. This is Davik's smuggling ship.
Oh, I've seen this little ship before plenty of times. Used to make runs for the exchange, didn't it? Korriban's nice and remote. The kind of place the exchange likes. You don't need to worry about me saying anything. I don't give a whit what you do with your ship. Smuggling's what the Hawk was made for, though.
Who are you?
Oh, nobody special. I just do the routine maintenance work for the ships that come in. I used to see the Hawk here all the time.
I just asked that question. Can I ask you some questions?
Sure can.
What can you tell me about Korriban?
It's a pretty barren planet, to tell the truth. Not of much interest to anyone. Unless you're a Sith, I guess. They seem to think this place is something special.
Even a Sith thinks something is special. Okay. Why do you think that... Why do the Sith think Korriban
Probably
is special?
Probably all them ruins they found on the surface. That's the reason they built their academy here, I guess. To dig all them ruins up.
There's a Sith Academy here?
There's people that come here from all over Sith space to try and join the Academy. Most of them die, I hear. Pretty gruesome business, that.
You look like you're wearing a Sith outfit. Anyway, how does someone get to the ruins?
You don't. Not unless you're a Sith in the Academy. They're the only ones allowed on the surface. They pay Zerka to ship things in and out, I guess, but that's all closely monitored.
Of course. How does someone get into the Academy?
There's all kinds of hopefuls in the colony trying to get in. Why don't you ask one of them?
He's wearing one of the Sith uniforms. What? Have you ever heard of a star map? No, he has
star
not.
Star map? You mean like a navigation chart?
Yeah, sure. Yes, but much older. Perhaps in the ruins?
Sith found a star map in those ruins. Nobody's ever mentioned it.
Oh, so... Do you know how to reach... Okay, no, I've asked all these questions. Thanks,
yep.
I'll be going.
Take care now.
That guy's cool. All right, you know what? He's cool. Even though he's wearing the other side clothing, that's fine. Wait, there's two of them. Yeah, I'm going to save, because I don't know what's going to happen. And Juhani's thing is going. Oh, I got to talk to Juhani. What am I doing? Talk to her now.
Our blood seethes at the thought of that man still running free. I cannot stand still while I think about it, but I will not give in to the dark side either.
He will pay for his crimes, though.
He will most likely be following us. Me. If we could find him first, then he may not be able to set in motion whatever he has in store for us.
Whoa, he's gonna set a trap for us? That's crazy. Anyway, you know what? The story's not over, then. We're gonna meet him again? Maybe that's why not too many people... has got this done before. Okay, and that thing didn't... Why is Jolie there? Anyway, I need to talk to Jolie again soon. Are you still... Okay, it's the same. Ah, I see. Another Jedi came to small Korriban. Yes. Good to meet you. How do you know I am... I'm a Jedi. Well, from the lightsaber you're carrying, naturally. Only Jedi carries ones like that, correct? There are many people who come to Korriban from throughout Sith space, hoping to join the Academy. Some of them are Jedi who left the Order. You will get into the Academy for certain. I understand Jedi who have left the light side are made very welcome. So I imagine. But enough of that. It is very nice to see that the Ebon Hawk has returned. Everyone likes my ship and not me. I have not seen that ship for some time indeed. Since you're a regular to our little colony, the docking fee is only 25 credits. Alright. persuade? That is not necessary, is it? Do I get Sith points? Persuade? That's not necessary, is it? Of course. Here's 25 credits. Excellent. Anyway, can I shoot? No. Yes. No. No. Yes. Do it. Don't do it. I'll be on my way. Enjoy your stay on Dresh Day? That was on Korriban, not Dresh Day. Anyway, you. Oh, he's a Circa. Oh, Zirka. Not Circa. Well, Circus too, since they're
worth about your business,
the Sith,
please, citizen.
Oh, that's Circa. But I thought Sith wore armor like that too. My goodness, who knows? Oh, boy, this is bad. Oh, this is bad. Oh, I just saved. I'm
no,
okay.
That
no,
is
I'm
the
okay.
Wrong answer. Again, you pathetic hopefuls can't possibly all be this stupid, can you?
Please, Master Chardin, give us a chance. We'll do anything to get into the academy. Oh, why? I gotta help them.
I'm no master yet, but I like the sound of that. All right, one more question. But a lot of you is trying my patience. All right, let's say you become a Sith and I am your commanding officer. I give you an order to spare the life of an enemy. Do you do it?
Oh, no.
Of course, Chardin. Anything you command us.
We would never
wrong
you. No.
Oh.
No. Do you honestly believe that the Sith are in need of such sniveling cowards? Mercy is a weakness. If you
right, for the Sith.
Weakness, it is your duty to kill him and show true authority, true power. That is why the Sith are strong.
Thank you, Chardin. We understand now. No, they don't.
Don't understand. And you never will. You wouldn't survive 5 seconds in the academy. The other students would tear you apart. Bah,
they will.
I can't be bothered with fools. Perhaps I should. You, Jedi,
planning on...
you're looking to get in the academy, are you not? Well, of course you are. Why else would you be here? Let me pose a question to you. These hopefuls will never survive in the academy. A lesson must be taught here, but I am at a loss as to what form it should take.
Oh, this is rich.
I wasn't talking
oh
to you. I'm thinking to spare them the effort of being killed and do it myself. Perhaps I shall turn their skin inside out. Or force lightning. Yes, it's a most
boring
impressive display. Or perhaps a bit of humiliation is in order. I could easily strip off their tunics and make them run through the colony. Or they could lose all control of their bodily functions.
That's just gross and messy.
I just can't seem to decide.
You can't just kill them. Ooh, why? What did they do? Why are you asking me? all of them. I guess they all lead to nothing. Except that totally points me out. Why? What did they
do?
We
didn't do anything. Please help us. Silence. It's not what they did so much as what they didn't do, which is prove
right
themselves worthy. I'm exhausted from dealing with their mewlings, so please decide for me, will you?
Mewlings? What is a mewling? Let them go. That is my decision. No way, leave me out of it. Perhaps just scare them a little. No. No, no, and let them go. That's my decision.
Let them go? And what could possibly convince me to do that?
Me? Persuade. They aren't worth your time. Killing them is wrong, you know that, because I'll kill you if you don't. That sounds very Sith, though. Because they aren't worth your time.
No, I think it's you who isn't worth my time. Them I prefer to kill. Just feel lucky I don't squish you while I'm at it.
No! I need way more persuasion. Way more persuasion. Light side points gained. Wow. Alright, well that's not how you gain light side points. You guys should not be dealing with the Sith. Maybe I'm not going to take the blame for this. You shouldn't be trying to get into the Sith Academy. Especially by the way you're thinking. You got to always think about gaining the upper hand, and you are too nice. But my persuasion sucks so badly that I cannot even say, oh, they're not even worth it. They could, either way, they really weren't worth killing. Anyway, Bree! Greetings. Welcome to Korriban. Is there anything you need? You can talk to me. What? Merchandise. Not right now. Okay, merchandise. Weapons. Connections. You'll need them. What sort of connections? Mandalorian raiders occasionally drop by needing to get some sort of extra credits that they can't sell in a civilized systems. They treat me well, I treat them well, it works out really. So, if you need weapons, alright, can I see your merchandise? Certainly. Carth Warblade, what? Vibro Double Blade. Cassius Fett's Heavy Pistol. A Bothan Shrieker? Okay, these are different looking things. Cool, okay, mines and whatever, disruptor rifles. Cool, anyway, close. Back again, merchandise. Why so? There's a lot of Sith on this planet. This is where they come to study. Obnoxious brats, the lot of them. Just between you and me, I never understand why anyone thinks Darkseid and Hooligan should be the same thing. But they are definitely dangerous. So that's why you'll probably need weapons. Ha, not that they'll be much help. Okay, let me see your merchandise. And okay, so now it sends me to the same thing. Weapons and merchandise with two different things.
Well, there isn't much to do in Dresh Day, except have a drink till your ship's ready to go.
Dresh Day is a nice name for a planet, and Korriban.
I can't wait to get back to the core systems. This planet is dangerous with all those Sith.
Look here, my dear friends.
Around.
We have some newcomers to the colony. Led
go
by
away.
Jedi, no less. I don't
darn right
seen
I am.
Any of them before, have you?
I hate Jedi, and these fallen ones are worse. They always get into the academy, and they think they're better than the rest of us.
Great. Just what we needed. Some punks to come steal our lunch credits.
Smart-mouthed newcomers to boot.
Looks pretty fresh to me, Lashow.
That's what I thought. Well, stranger, I don't know whether you're aware of this or not, but here on Korriban, the Sith do as they please. And we are Sith. Quite literally, whether you live or die depends upon our whim. What do you think of that,
Double yawn. I think that's a lot of responsibility for simple scum like you. I must have picked that when I was playing as on the dark side. I must have. You can try to kill me. You'll fail, but you can try. Oh, I like that. And that's not going to give me Sith points. I don't think there's any need for hostilities. Oh, that's like super nice. No, you can try to kill me. You'd fail, but you can
those
try.
Those are very brave words for such an insignificant person. Do you not realize how many Sith are here in Dresh Day?
Is this
probably 30.
How many guesses do we get?
Do not
let me kill this one, Lasher.
No, come on.
Now,
come
let's
on.
Not be hasty. Perhaps our
raffle.
Friend here could yet offer up some amusement. What do you say?
Oh.
Amuse us. Make us laugh, and we might just consider allowing you to live.
Jokes? Oh, I got jokes. Be careful, you might be heading for more trouble than you can handle. Ooh, I like it. If you really want to fight, just make the first move. It'll be your last. Ooh, I like that. Okay. These two Mandalorians are out in the woods. Oh, what kind of joke starts off with Mandalorians in the woods? Please don't hurt me. I don't want to fight. No, I'm not looking for trouble, but I'm not here to amuse you. Ooh, well, that's kind of nice. Be careful, you might be heading for more trouble than you can handle.
What?
I think someone just stood up to you, Lasho.
Shut up, fool, unless you want to be next.
Yeah? Anytime.
Stop it, ooh. This is boring. Let's just go back to the academy.
Fine, we'll go.
Bye-bye.
As for you, I'll find you later. Trust me on that.
Oh, I'll send my kisses to you. Go away, you are all way not my level. There you go. That's my only comeback. I figure I can get out of that. Anyway, could I get light side points out of that? Probably. But I wanted to give her some attitude because there's no need for me to be talking about two Mandalorians in the woods. What kind of joke starts off like that? I had a few ready to go, and I'm glad I didn't have to use them because they're probably, who knows how good they were. Perspective Sith? Citizen? Are you have a name? Are you have a name?
You've heard of that awful business on Edean, yes? Our corporate outpost there has been destroyed by the Wookiee savages. This
that was me.
The use of Wookiee labor considerably. We may even have to abandon the planet completely. Well, what can you do? Sorry, was there something you needed?
Uh, What does Circa do here on Korriban? No, frig that. Who cares? What? Can I ask you some questions about the colony? How can one reach the ruins on the surface?
Circa sends freighters to the surface every now and again to ferry artifacts to the core. The men are not allowed out of their ships, however, as only Sith are allowed on the surface. Beyond that, I really can't say.
Persuade. Can't say or don't
know.
Does
it matter? I don't intend to speak of it regardless.
Darn it, my persuasion sucks so badly. What can you tell me about the colony? Blah, blah, blah. I'll be going. No, I refuse to come back here again. You.
Oh, entertainment can be found at the local cantina, provided by Circa, of course.
Oh, because this room is so entertaining that that was my question to you. There's nothing in here, Carth. Not now. Okay, I did it, but I can't walk. I can't walk at the best of times. Why are they walking in front of me? All right, there's nothing to actually scan. That's not even a door. It's fake. It's all lies. I'm going to have to soon start saving, because this person's going to cut me off. That person's going to cut me off. And the other person in the room is going to... save. Save now. Okay, here we go. Yeah, him. You. You there, human. You are the one flying to Ebon Hawk now? I saw you disembarking earlier. Who wants to know? Yes, the Ebon Hawk is my ship. Is that so? Well, you can tell Davik that my people are spitting plasma over this. We've been waiting for our shipment for a month now. I suppose we should be grateful that the shipment survived Taurus at all, though, right? Anyway, hand it over and let's finish this. Hand what over? What are you talking about? Wait a minute. You don't work for Davik? Just how is it you happen to be flying the Ebon Hawk anyway? Davik's dead, I presume. I stole the Ebon Hawk from him. When a planet explodes, you got to expect a few changes. Davik's dead, hey? Maybe you can still help me with something? We had arranged for several kilograms of spice to be shipped to us here aboard the Ebon Hawk. Perhaps Davik left it on board? I suspect if it is, it would be in a container we gave him, locked and requiring a code. Might you have seen such a thing, human? Yeah. Because this gets you Sith points. I'm absolutely positive. If I go and get that and give this spice to him, this red spice, I think it's red, it's probably like curry or something, it gets me dark side points. I know it does. I may have. How much is it worth to you? I could take a look for it. I don't want to get involved in this. Are you sure? The people I represent could make it well worth your while. Well, how well worth my while? I said I don't want to get involved. Fine, I'll look for it, your container. And I'll never... What do I do? I don't want to get Sith points by accident by like accepting the quest but never giving him the curry powder. Super spicy edition. Fine, I'll take a look for your container. Excellent. Set the code on the container to red 47. When you get the spice, bring it to me. I'll wait for you. Journal entry added. Okay. I'm glad I didn't get the thing where Bobber to unfinished business. You have encountered an alien by the name of Lurz, who mentions that there's a container on board the Ebon Hawk filled with spice that Davik had agreed to bring him. You have agreed to return to Lurz with the spice. He has provided you with a security code, Red 47. I might take it and... Can I warp? No. Darn it, I'm not going back that far. That's right, I'm not going back that far. Rodian? Toll? Oh, you're probably one of those Pazok players. Greetings, sentient. Are you willing to engage in... No, goodbye. Smealy out of here, too. I am out of here. I'm not... Pilot, you have a thing, a job classification
you
name.
You own the Ebon Hawk, don't you? Wish I could fly a bird like that.
It's a ship, not a bird.
Greetings, friend. Fellow pilot, are you? Wouldn't mind taking a spin in the Ebon Hawk myself. Sleek ship, that one.
Oh, here's the keys, man. Here, have a test flight. Does everyone here know about the Ebon Hawk? What about me?
In a small colony like this, everyone knows everyone's business.
It's better than thinking too much about all the Sith lurking about here. The Hawk's been in and out of here for ages. And out of the way, Starport is a good place for, privateers. Not saying you are one.
I don't even know what a privateer is. So I am not a smuggler, if that's what you mean.
Wouldn't make any difference to me. Just wish I had a ship like that myself. Business is steady here with the Sith, but it's a boring haul.
In case you're forgetting, partner, they don't exactly want us talking about their business.
Ah, who cares about them?
Right.
I've seen some of those things they're digging up in those ruins in the valley. Pretty creepy, if you ask me.
Tell me, what have they been digging
up? Weird artifacts. Looks like alien stuff. Maybe aliens lived on Korriban a long time ago. Who knows?
Don't be stupid.
Wasn't
was
he the one?
I was talking to Sith, and he said there are tombs there dating back to when the Sith were here in ancient times.
There were Sith here in ancient times? Sounds like he was feeding you a line. Korriban's only been settled for a short time.
So says you. He said the planet was settled by the Sith long time ago. And then they all left or something. Those tombs are really important to him.
Tombs, eh? That makes the stuff they send us even creepier. Wish I didn't have to haul it around.
He was the one who was like, we should be talking about our jobs. Oh, you know, or just artifacts from... My goodness. Anyway, where do you take these things?
We used to haul everything to Terrace, and the Sith would take it off our hands there. Not sure where we'll be bringing it now.
Wait, okay, I was going to say, if they left it on Terrace and they themselves blew it up... That's pretty stupid of them, but okay, no, they take it off Taurus, so they had their stuff, okay. Do you know any of these artifacts?
No, we're not due for another shipment for at least another week.
I already know where you take them. Why is that question even there? How do you get to these excavations exactly?
It's in a valley on the surface, beyond some mountains to the east. No land route. That's why they have us fly in.
Shows what you know. The Academy has a route through the mountain. That's how all their students get to the excavation site.
Well, regardless, the Sith don't let anybody near that valley. Even when we land, they watch us like a Draberian hawk and want us gone quickly.
Wait, can I call my ship the Draberian Hawk instead of the Ebon Hawk? What is a Draberian? I need to know these things. So no one... could sneak into the valley by
Not
ship?
A chance. You'd be better off sneaking through the Academy if you want to go to the valley.
Ha! Now that'd be a sight to see.
I will gladly be doing that. I'll be
sure
going
thing.
Then.
Good flying, friend.
I hope so. I hope no one shoots down my Ebon Hawk. Look, there's finally one item on this entire planet. No, I'm joking. There's a little bit more. Just that was the first one I've ran into in here. Oh, you have a name. Oh, thank goodness. Is that girl here? She's not here. I must have to do something. Oh, I have to talk. Come back. And then she'll be here. Oh, right. Okay. Greetings, sentient. You are the former of the... Yes. The owner of the Ebon Hawk. Or its latest owner, at least. I am Mika. You know what? I'm going to call you Mika, because why not? Manager of this establishment. What? Korriban Cantina, not Dresde. Anyway, you know what? You know something about the Ebon Hawk? Only what I hear from rumors, sentient. The Hawk has been a frequent visitor of Korriban in the past, though often with a different owner. In all fairness, I should tell you that many of its past owners were suspicious of being smugglers, slavers, and pirates. Great. It was even whispered that some of them worked for the exchange. But I always found the Hawk's owners to be excellent citizens of fine character. The kind of people I prefer to do business with. Much better than the Sith, at least. Wow. Do I need to know these things? Because we've already asked them, right? Do you know anything about the star maps? He doesn't know. We can tell me about the Sith excavations. We already found that out. The Sith Academy. And anything interesting going on here. The cantina has been provided by the Circa Corporation. Really? And it is a quiet place. This is as I prefer it. Elsewhere on Dresday is a not always safe or quiet. Dresday is run by the Sith, I'm assuming. That's what we just said. The Sith are not always pleasant in their dealings with others. Thanks, that's all I need to know. As I desire, I guess I am a sentient, and yeah, I'm ahead of myself again. I need to go. Who are you?
Trying to get into the Sith Academy. Around here, they call us hopefuls.
Why would you want to get into the Sith Academy?
Well, that's the only way to become a Sith, isn't it? In the Academy, you learn to use the Force.
Why not join the Jedi?
After the Sith conquer the galaxy, there aren't going to be any more Jedi, are there? I guess I'd rather join the winning side.
What? Oh my goodness! How dare... Anyway, she doesn't know that... fine. We're gonna win. We always win. Yes, but on this game, the Sith kind of wins on this game, but not on the next game. So, you're just on the wrong game, lady, that's all. Why would you want to get... I already asked that. What do you think your chances are?
I thought they were good, but I've been here for days now, and I haven't drawn any attention at all. I suppose that might be good. I don't know. Some of the attention the Sith have shown to other hopefuls has been pretty deadly.
You mean they're not alive? How kind of deadly. How does someone get into the Academy?
I wish I knew, to tell you the truth. You have to impress one of the Sith, I guess. Either way, it's Uthura Ban who makes the final decision. She's a Twi'lek Sith Master, I hear. Very high rank. She's the one who decides which hopefuls make it in and which ones don't.
Where is this Uthura Ban?
I really couldn't say. I hear that sometimes she comes out into the colony to drink at the cantina, though. But I guess she could be anywhere.
All right, that's all I need to know. Thank you.
Goodbye.
You're awfully nice for being a Sith. Too nice, actually. So, do I want to run back and get my curry stuff now? Or do I... Whatever, let's do it. Just wait, I could probably run super fast. Check this... Don't check that out. Check this out. I got level 2 stuff. Oh, look at that. Light speed almost. Sure, let's go with that. That wasn't me. That was the Sith. Yeah, look how we're over here. I don't know where I'm going though. This way probably. Yeah. Okay. Well, I know where the container is cuz we did find it before. I clicked on it and it said it was locked. Are you ready now, old man, grumpy dude? Talk.
This thing with Joggy, is there some...
Goodbye. Your choice for not talking to me. I can't believe I have dorky-looking ears now. Oh, my ears glow, too. Great, wonderful. I'm just gonna keep it. If it didn't have any light, I'd probably get rid of it. But what happens if I get Sith points from this? I'm not thinking this through. Whatever. It's only I need all the Jedi points I can get. Even light side points, not dark side points. Anyway, open. The secret compartment is still locked. Enter the code. A hidden compartment is now unlocked. I open it again. Ooh, whoa. That was that. Okay, get items. Get items. Journal entries added. Oh, okay, so I don't get the dark side points until I trade it to him. And I'm going to keep it for myself. So is it... Can I not truly seriously see it? No, where are you? See? It's red! The term spice has come to describe a wide variety of stimulants mined on a number of worlds. But a higher... converted glitterism found on Kessel is by far the most precious. Did I read that right? But a highly coveted glitterism found on Kessel is by far the most precious. I'm just gonna go with a curry, even though it's not. Curry will be fine. I'm not giving him my curry. It's mine. I found it. It's my ship. I'm gonna go with you. And, I still need Carth. And Carth, with his snarky attitudes, given given the Sith their what fors to. Okay, if I hit up, yeah, totally so good at this game. Anyway, there you go. This wasn't too bad of a detour, was it? Because I'm not a, this is technically smuggling. Like, if I deliver this, this is me smuggling spice across the borders and giving this to him. So if I talk to him and say no, do I get light side points? There you are. Do you have the spice? Yes, I do. So you do. That does indeed look like the amount that Davik promised. Very well. 1,000 credits for your exchange of the spice. I don't work for Davik, remember? I want more. Whoa! Fair enough. Make it 2,000 credits or I hand the package over to the authorities. Ooh, I like it. I don't want to do none of this. Just take the spice. I don't want your credits. No, I don't. How do I get out of this? Fair enough. No, persuade, no. I don't work for Davik, remember? I want more. That sounds evil. Just take the spice. I don't want it or your credits. Oh, I don't want the spice too. It's not really curry, right? So that. Are you certain? It is odd to meet a human who is uninterested in free credits, but have it your way. Allow me to take the spice off your hands. My employees will be most pleased. Tell me, will you be interested in earning more credits? No, not really. It is your decision. I wish you well, human. Oh, okay, so I didn't consider. Okay, if you take money or bribe more. Oh, I got rid of the illegal spice. You know what? That's probably a better thing than having that on my ship or on my possession. I didn't think that through until just now. I'm glad I talked to him. I thought I clicked on that door and it took a little, had a little delay to that door. Sith doors, nowhere near as good as the Jedi doors. Oh, look how pretty this is. This is planet's pretty bare too, though. It's just rocks and that. Utility, there's a thingy here. I know there is. E, Q, Q, see? I knew it. And there's another one on the other side, I think. No, okay, there isn't. Yes, there is. Why did it scan over? Anyway, it doesn't matter. This game is old, and I forgive it, because it's pretty good for, with story and stuff. Don't block me in here. Okay, good. Alright, we're leaving, maybe. So I'm going to save before I cross this bridge, though. Because this, I got to save these people. I need to save them. Because if I don't save them, it's gonna be the same thing that happened to the last three people that I tried to save. I got light side points out of it, sure, but they still died. Hi there. I have to stand at attention. Please don't distract me, whoever you are. What are you doing? I'm trying to prove my worth to enter the Sith Academy here. We were told that if we stood here long enough, we would be worthy. We've been here for so many days. I'm so hungry. Some of us have died, but I must be strong. I must keep standing. Are you crazy? You have to stop this. Here, I have a bit of... You have to stop! No, I can't. You must get into the... I must get into the academy. Mikhail is the Sith over there, watching us. He told us we have to do this. I must be strong, Mikhail. Will find me worthy soon, I hope. You are fools. See, like, I know the Sith thing. I know what he's doing. And that's not how you do. You disobey the orders and you attack him. Anyway.
Is there something specific you wanted?
Nice hairdo. Are you Michelle? I am. Wow, he lets me get away with that. I have to do something to those men. They're dying. Why are you making them stand there? You know what? No, that's
that
thought one.
That is the whole point. Personally, I think it's wonderful fun. Those fools actually think that if they stand there long enough, I'll let them become a Sith. Idiots. A Sith is not a bantha, all endurance and no brains. A Sith would fight for his life, no matter the odds. If these rot grubs are as stupid as they seem, then they deserve their fate.
Then I demand you stop this at once. Yeah, sure, let's go with that. Attitude.
You demand. Why would I listen to you? I'll do as I please. And if watching these fools starve themselves amuses me, that's what I'll do.
You should not toy with people's lives.
Oh, what a sweet guy. He should get the Sith Congeniality Medal.
Hmm. A bit boring standing out here all day, however. I think I'll go for some dinner. It will be fun to think of them while I gorge myself. They'll still be here in an hour or two, surely. I suggest you run along before I decide to make you part of the fun.
I will kick your butt all over this rock formation. Get out of here. All right, there you go. He's gone now. You were talking to Mikhail. I saw you. Where did he go? Did he tell you I was worthy? Persuade. Mikhail is tricking you. He'll never let you in the academy. Failure. No, darn it! You're wrong. I must wait here to be worthy. You're trying to trick me. But I... Go now and tempt me no more. I will be strong. Okay, well, he doesn't die, but the next two will. Especially this guy.
Leave me be. I won't listen to your manipulations. I will make it into the academy. Just a few hours longer. Just a few hours, surely.
Shirley? Who is Shirley?
You talk to Meckle? Have I proved Meckle. My worth? Did he say anything?
He's tricking you.
No, it can't be. You're wrong. I can't have wasted my life.
Thunk, and he died. Alright, see, this is why you need persuasion in this game. Hopefully you've all learned your lesson. Okay, I can't help them. They are not hopefuls. Oh, okay, well, you looked really cool for a second, and then...
Sith, nor do you bear the medallion of a student of this facility. Please, leave at once.
Are you the dude on Taurus? You got the same voice. Oh my goodness, you lived. I need to get inside, and I have been sent to speak to the master of the academy. Like they're going to post a guard who can easily be persuaded or mind-tricked. Right.
No one gets inside, citizen. Messages and deliveries must be relayed through official Sith channels only.
What's this medallion you mentioned?
It is a device given to one who has been accepted into the academy, but has not yet proved worth as a student. If one of the Sith decides you are worthy, you will be given one, which you must then take to Yathura Ban, who I believe is in the cantina. It is she who decides which hopefuls enter the academy.
Sorry, Duxon, I was really zoned into this game. Hey, Duxon, that first move was so skillful. I would agree so. I'll be going now. Where did my mouse go? Click away. Click back in, and there's my mouse. I'll be going.
On your way, citizen.
You are a citizen, first of all, and there is really nothing going on here. I need to, like, refresh my thing, because all I see is a major load screen, and I do not want that to be loading the whole time. Are you all right, computer? Is Steam kicking in and be like, oh, there's another game to update? Because probably. Are you finally ready? There you go. Duxon's still there. Good, good, and good. Let's go. Alright. That's way better. Stuck. Carth, let's talk now.
What do you need?
What talk?
About what? I'll understand if we...
Dude, we're here. Okay, no, nothing's gonna happen until we get off this planet, okay? Or help Carth's son. We must help his son. My persuasion sucks, though. I'm really worried about that. I may need to level up and get one at least to force persuade. And I should, like, do that now, but I really need these levels. I need every single level I can get. Fine, whatever. Persuade. Yeah, I wish. Too bad. Feats. Really? No. Yeah, no, these are feats. Okay, never mind. Do I want my lightsaber now? I'm going to be fighting a lot now. And then I'll use those super rolls later. Whatever, do it. Affect mind, and then the next one is dominate mind. And it is universal. So they were nice to the Sith and us Jedis. But yeah, enables persuasive force and extra options, which I should have had done anyway. In the first place. There we go, done. I could still level up. But I'm losing way too many levels. I haven't even gone through Korriban. Oh, and there's so many rough fights. Okay, there she is. That's where I thought she would be, but I was ahead of myself again. Yeah, Yathura Ben. I'm gonna save because I don't trust you.
Is there something you need, Jedi? Make it good, for I have little patience.
There were two Mandalorians in the woods, and why do you call me Jedi?
You think you're a fool? You think I do not recognize a lightsaber when I see it? You are far
this
from
is
the first Jedi who has come here after all. Willing
light.
To abandon that decrepit order of yours.
A torch. This is a torch. What? Anyway, are you Yathura Ben?
Obviously, you have been told of me. Is it your desire, then, to train at the Academy? Do you wish to become a Sith human?
Is there a lie and I can say yes? Why would I want to join the Sith?
An interesting question, and not one I hear often. For most, the benefits of becoming a Sith are quite obvious. We wield ultimate power, my friend.
Do you? Do you really?
To taste freedom and to know victory. Nothing is as glorious as bending the Force to your will.
Wait, why would you be bending the Force? The Force is everywhere. How do you bend things that are everywhere? That's impossible. A lot of hopefuls end up dead. That doesn't seem glorious.
We make no apologies for the weak. If you cannot clench your fist and know when the moment comes to strike, there is no place for you amongst us. Of those who come to train, those who are weak return home. If they are both weak and foolish, they die. But it was their choice to come.
And what about the Jedi?
Hide-bound relics who burden themselves with tradition and with the protection of the weak and ungrateful. They are pitiful and misguided. Why would you take a gift as glorious as the Force and squander it? Weaken yourself deliberately and shackle yourself to outdated mores. Our gift has made us superior. It is our rightful place to rule. How can any deny that? Yet the Jedi do so and call us evil because we do not.
No, we call you evil because you kill and you conquer and you destroy. That's why. But to be able to use the Force so freely, like you say, is not a bad thing, I guess. But not for evil, though. I don't know. There's too many, like, using something good for evil makes it bad, but it was never intended for evil in the first place. Anyway, and same vice versa the other way. You don't consider yourself evil?
Is the Sarkath beast who dominates his jungle evil? The Tukata who leaps on the squall bug for the kill? These are things of nature, of the universe. We are
You're not
different from this. The Force
okay,
is
go
part
for
of
it.
The universe, part of the same
right.
laws. We were gifted to set us above the rest. To deny nature is foolish.
To elevate yourself is already wrong. Anyway, let's not fight the Sith here with just words. She's not going to listen to me anyway. A lot of hope said that, but you serve the dark side of the Force, don't you? And where does Darth Malak fit in all of this?
You know the name. Malak is the strongest of us, and the strongest always rules.
Really?
At least until one who is stronger can take it from him. That is our way. Survival of the fittest. You are always on guard, always lean for the kill. We promote it, for through this, the Sith are stronger.
You kill each other.
If a Sith is proven to be weak, and if the time is right, the Force rewards the cunning and the mighty. Step up to the challenge if you dare, or turn tail and run.
So if the world is about an RPG, no wonder the Sith is always winning, because they fight and kill and level up. And yeah, that's why. Anyway. None of this. But you serve the dark side of the Force,
it
don't
is the
you?
It's the Jedi who serve the Force, trying to discern its wishes like frightened old men staring at the stars. The Force serves us. We shape it to our will. We are its master. The Jedi deny their darkness, but we revel in it. We allow it to fuel our strength.
Oh my goodness, really? These are my options. But the dark side is evil. It corrupts. A lot of hopefuls. I see. About joining. I don't want to say that.
You've heard enough, have you? So what is it to be? Are you here to be a Sith or not?
No, but no, I'm not interested. Yes, I went. Never mind, I have to go. Oh my goodness. No, I'm not interested.
No? Why might that be? There is something odd about you, human, that I cannot place. Obviously, am I super? You're a Jedi. One who is very strong in the Force, it seems. So were you a part of the Order for very long? Did they train you?
Is it because I'm super cute with my glowing ear things? Because, I mean, I don't know. That could be the only super odd thing about me. No, I don't know what you're talking about. Yes, only a little, very little. Yes, I'm a fallen Jedi, if you must know. What difference does it make?
Perhaps none. Perhaps all the difference in the world. Either way, you possess enough raw power to intrigue me greatly. With that kind of power, you could become a great Sith. Perhaps.
Perhaps.
If I let you. Does that interest you?
No. It does. Wait, no, it doesn't. That is my first force persuade. Yes, I want you to accept me into the academy. Persuade lie. Yes, it does. I wish to become the Sith. Does that keep me out? Okay, because like lying usually tends to get you in trouble. But now, hear me out. I'm only talking for this game only. If I persuade lie because I truly don't want to be a Sith, I wish to be a Jedi, and I say, yes, it does, I wish to become a Sith, but I'm lying, do I still get light side points because I'm still being true to the light side of things? Or do I just say persuade? Oh, okay. Force persuade is not going to work, by the way, so I'm going to lie. And she's... It's not going to work. No, it doesn't.
A pity. And here I hadn't even decided yet. Well, human,
yeah.
Should you change your mind, you know where to come.
That's right, take that. Anyway, wait, I can't go anywheres. Darn it, I gotta talk to you.
What do you wish?
Yes, may, hi. To bug you, I want to join the Sith.
Ah, so you are just another hopeful after all.
No.
Or are you? There is something odd about you that I cannot place. Obviously,
we had this.
Jedi.
We had this conversation. I don't know what you're talking about.
As you wish. Play your little game, Jedi, if you must. Either way, I sense an intriguing amount of power within you. With that kind of power...
Blobbity blah, lie.
I see. Somehow, however, I am unconvinced. No, my friend. I'll not be the one to bring you into our academy. If one of the other Sith accept you and give you a medallion, then perhaps. But otherwise... Not today. Run along now.
Darn it, I can't persuade anything. If I probably can't even persuade attack to like not whatever. Find somebody and somebody's up here waiting for me to kick their butts. Yes, them. I'm gonna kick all your butts. You're just standing there
hey,
in my way.
What's this? Looks like we found ourselves a bit of sport, my friends.
This is
oh good.
Good. I want to celebrate my acceptance into the academy.
Me too. So how about it, chump? Ready to die? I'm eager to blow off some steam after those tests.
Really? You don't want to pick a fight here. Are you sure you want to die? Bring it on. Oh my goodness, all of these are good except that one, which is the light side one. Are you sure you want to die? Hey, I think that was a threat.
That's pretty funny. Why should we be scared of you?
Take another step and I'll show you. Oh, I like that one. Because I killed plenty of Sith before. Now, run along, boys. Persuade, because I am not a snot-nosed punk who's biting off more than they can chew. What? That's why persuade. It's gonna fail. Oh my goodness. I want to play this game again with, like, maximum persuasion. Because I've killed plenty of Sith before. Run along,
hey,
boys.
This one has killed Sith.
You picked the wrong place to say that. We'll score big points for bringing in your body, I'm sure.
Wait.
Down you go!
Who's throwing sabers around? Stop throwing things! That's dangerous. That guy in the middle. Him. Citizen. Hey, stop stealing life. Alright, I'm gonna start trying now. Oh, he's going down. Citizen, it is totally not safe here. Wow, these guys are going down faster than Faster than something. Are you all right, citizen? You just stood in the middle. Lightsabers were flung. And you're just like, oh, they're all dead. I'll just walk away then. Give me your thing that you're supposed to have. Because I just kicked all your butts. Thank you for your Sith medallion. Kicked all their butts, I did. Q? Nothing? Alright, cool. There, mine. Anyone else wish to challenge my glowing ear thing? Oh, what's this?
Once you become a Sith, you can do anything.
You can really?
Feel the power coursing through you.
Coursing.
Fools can compare to me.
Please, friend, we are pleased at your success, please. But...
You're jealous. You're jealous of my power. You think you deserve this medallion, don't you? Let's just see.
Oh.
See? I have the power to do anything.
That's strange. Anyone can do that. Somebody help me, please.
You would ever belong beside me in the academy. I'd rather kill you now and save us the trouble.
I'm in the background. I'll save you.
I have an audience.
Yes.
Look, Jedi. Just keep walking. Unless you want some of the same.
Oh, sorry, but I'm not going to let you kill that woman. Ha, that's pretty good hero-ish. Yeah, let's see how tough you are then. Oh, that's just asking too brazen. I'm not that brazen. Do you want it? It has... Oh, no. Sorry, I'm not going to let you kill that woman.
You can't stop me. You first, human.
I'm gonna front flip all over your face. Oh, never mind. I'm gonna walk towards you and then swing.
You asked for this. Here.
Oh, he just threw his thing at Carth. And he's dead. Yeah, I thought so. Do I get a double medallion? If I run it with two medallions, gonna start throwing these medallions around like. Like somebody who gives out these medallions. Anyway, any more people wish to challenge me? If this is what the Sith has, they don't stand a chance. Oh, cool! I got the upgrade heal, which means if I'm poisoned and stuff, it also removes those effects. Nobody else? All right. Well, I mean, I'm glad nobody sees that. That I'm just going around killing all. I'm defending people. That's what I'm doing. Which light side stuff? Of course. Way to go. Way to kill an innocent and get yourself killed because you thought your powers made you invincible. Those groups just wanted to celebrate and got themselves killed. They disappear after a while, though, of course. And I have an extra medallion here. No, why would I give anyone that? Well, just break them.
You have a medallion.
Two. So what does that mean? That's right, got a problem with that? Wow, it's mine, you're not getting it? No, out of my way, what? So, what does that mean?
Address that. The Sith who gave you that must have mentioned it represented your acceptance. All what? You have to do is bring it to your Thuraban at the cantina, and you're in. Might you have any advice for me? How did you obtain it?
Forget it, you'll never be worthy. You just got to keep trying, I guess. Let's just say, I didn't get this the normal way.
So there is a secret. I knew there had to be. Would you tell me what it is? I'll do anything to know.
Persuade. You don't want to go to the academy. Trust me. Go home. You have to attack one of the Sith for it. Oh, that would not be good for you to do. Take it from me and the other... Take it from me or the other students, of course. That sounds pretty evil. You must show your bravery by jumping in the... That's evil! Persuade. You don't want to go there. Go home.
That's exactly where we're headed.
Family couldn't talk me out of this, and you sure aren't going to. Thanks anyway.
Darn it! I can't convince anyone because the persuasion sucks. Maybe if I put one in the persuasion, I'll be all right. Maybe, but I leveled up too many
you
times.
You again? What do you wish now?
Yeah, hi. I got two of these things.
So one of the others accepted you even after I did not. You're lucky, human. For I'm in a forgiving mood. I will
Whatever.
Take you to the academy. We shall see if you are ready to join the ranks of the Sith. I have only one other question. These companions of yours, they will not be coming with you, I presume.
Oh, they are slaves. Don't worry about them.
Yes, yes. We are only servants to the master. There's something odd about this servant of yours. No matter. Make sure they don't disturb your training or cause trouble.
Of course not.
You are responsible for them. Now, are you ready to go to the academy?
Not yet. No, I am. I actually am.
Then let
am.
Us leave. The master of the academy awaits you.
Can I click on this and then this? I can. Good. Okay, I did in time. I lost my clock.
Greetings,
now it's back. It's good.
Prospective students. It appears we have a late entry. Who do you bring before me, Uthura? A young human bristling with the Force?
A human that has had some training, it seems, Master Uthar. Very promising, I think.
Promising? Swirling Force!
That one's not worthy to lick spit off your shoes, Master.
I met this one in the colony. Unworthy, if you ask me.
That I'll judge for myself, thank you. Tell me, human, what do you know of the ways of the Sith? What preconceptions has your mind been polluted with?
You know what? I don't know. I wasn't ready for these questions, but because I've always gone through it as a Sith. But I am going to try to do everything as Jedi as possible. I've killed too many Sith to have preconceptions about them. Ooh, I like the attitude on that one. I don't know anything. Lies. I know that the Sith are powerful. No, lies. The Sith, they are, some of them are. The Sith are evil and have surrendered themselves to temptation. Oh, that's going to get me in trouble. The Sith do what? No. You know, I killed too many Sith to have preconceptions about them.
Most impressive, if it is true. Those who were too weak to stand against you deserve their fate. So expect
really?
Retribution from us. And as much you can learn from the Sith, and we from you. The Jedi equate the light with goodness and strength, and the dark
right.
with weakness and evil. That is their tradition, and it is truly no surprise that they cling to it for comfort. We, however, do not treat the Force as a burden. We treat it as a gift, a thing to be celebrated. We use it to acquire power over others. And why should we not? Because the Jedi say we should not. We are as the Force is meant to be. The Jedi would hide that from you. They would tell you the dark side is too quick, too easy. All so that they need never challenge the passions that lie within them. Joining with us means realizing your true potential. It means not stifling yourself solely for the sake of hidebound shamans and their antiquated notion of order. Be what you were meant to be. What say you, Lasho? Are you ready to learn the secrets of the dark side? Dare you?
I dare, Master Uthar. I am ready.
Brash and fiery, as expected. Turn that passion to your advantage, child. What of you, Meikle? Are you ready?
I am, Master. More than ready.
I sense much anger within you, young one. That is good. That will provide you power. And Shardan, what of you?
I am always ready.
I see. You had best gather your wits for the trial ahead, boy, or you will not last. And you, young human, does this interest you? Are you ready to learn more of what I speak?
What about my companions? I am ready to learn more. I don't know. But power with consideration is of morality is a weakness. Oh, well, am I going like, but am I going all smarts here? What? Power without consideration of morality is a weakness. Ooh, I like that one too, though. That does sound nice to say. What? And what of my companions? Or that one. You know what? What?
You are brave to argue, young one. I have met few
yeah.
students who would speak so openly to me. Ask yourself
well,
first what this morality is. How is it created? Who does it benefit? Where do your
everyone.
Notions of good and evil come from? You may
my
come
heart.
To the realization that morality is but an obstacle to overcome, or not. The discovery is yours to make, should you be ready. Now then. All of you five recruits have shown a degree of facility with the Force. You all
good.
Have the potential to become true Sith. Only one of you, however, will succeed. The one who succeeds will be admitted to the Academy as a full Sith. All others must wait until next year and try again. If you survive, my pupil, Uthura, shall be your teacher and master while you attempt to prove yourselves. Heed her words.
As Master
okay.
Uthar said, none of you are true Sith yet. For that to occur, one of you must do enough of worth, gain enough prestige to be selected. What is an act of worth? You must learn that for yourselves. Remember that you are competitors here. Fight for your destiny, or go home.
If you wish to gain a lead over your competitors, The first of you to learn the code of the Sith and tell me of it will be rewarded. The rest is for
Can
you
I
to discover.
Do that right
Welcome
now?
To the dark side, my children.
It's
Your
passion, strength,
true greatness lies here.
Passion, strength, power, victory. My chains are broken. Like I've done this route so many times that I just kind of know exactly that. Not that I am Sith, but it's just you're so strong. Ooh, dark Jedi Knight robes. I look good in this color for some reason. I don't know. I would assume black would be pretty snarly and stuff. Anyway, I guess I'm going to continue on because the time says keep going. All right, fine. Well, I will. I'm going to save here now that I'm in here. I guess. Yeah, there's really no turning back. I've made this decision. It's happening. Johnny, save me. Carth.
What do you need?
To talk.
What? I'll understand if we can't look for him right now, but if we could, it would be a...
Okay. He's absolutely stuck. Anyway, I think he's in one of these things here.
There
so
you are. My favorite prospect for the year.
Oh, my your favorite prospect?
Absolutely. By my estimation, you are far more likely to achieve the prestige necessary to join the Sith than any of the others. As a matter of fact, I am so certain of that I'm willing to offer you an opportunity of the once-in-a-lifetime variety. Would you like to hear it?
Sounds like an old song, but absolutely. Do I have a choice? But I don't even have any prestige yet. Absolutely.
Good. I do so adore someone who's willing to take a chance. As I said, you're no doubt going to be the one whom Uthar chooses to become a Sith. With my help, of course. Once that occurs, he will take you into the Valley of the Dark Lords to the tomb of Naga Sado to administer the final test. There you and I will be alone with him. The perfect time to, shall we say, arrange for a change in the Academy's leadership.
Oh, well, she just wants to take the thing for herself. What a true Sith. But there, I forget the good way to go. I think the good way is to take them both out. The good route is the hard route. You're like, no, I'm not going to go along with this, blah, blah, blah. I'm a Jedi and I will fight you both. It sucks because that's a two-on-one thing. If I agree with her and not tell him, or if I agree with her and then tell him, oh no, I have no idea which is the way to get light side points. What's so important about
this
tomb?
The tomb is an ancient ruin on the surface that was visited years ago by Darth Revan and Darth Malak. They discovered a star map there of great importance.
Darth Malak went there? Very interesting, isn't it, Master?
Reaching that map,
Carth,
as they did,
please,
is part of the
stop.
Final test. At any rate, it is not the tomb that is important. That Uthar will be alone is what is important.
You want me to kill Master Uthar? That's what is exactly what's going down. What's to stop me from telling him about this? She'll just pretend to deny it and just go to the tomb like nothing happens, right? And what's your part in this? Ooh, I want
to
know.
My part in this is to help you gain enough prestige and slow down the progress of the other hopefuls. I want you in that tomb when the time is right. We destroy Master Uthar together and I take his place. And you take your place at my side. A beautiful plan in its sheer simplicity.
I'm trying to go through my head on what I have to do there. Oh no. You want me to kill Master Uthar? How do I know this isn't some kind of test? Whatever. You
is
want me to kill him?
Is that such a daunting prospect? It is
no,
not as
question.
If I'm asking you to perform the task alone, or as if you will get nothing out of it. Master Uthar cannot prevail against us both. That's all there is to it. It is a very simple matter.
Okay, well, very well, I agree.
I'm so glad you see it my way. I will begin to make preparations for your final test. Your only worry now is to get there. Don't disappoint me.
Wait, no. Can you tell me about the code so I can get the thing, so I can go and get the quest? Those points, easy points.
I can help you understand it. Would you like to hear it? Peace is a lie.
Sure.
There is only passion. Through passion, I gain strength. Through strength, I gain power. Through power, I gain victory. Through victory, my chains are broken. The Force shall free me. Simple words.
My chains are broken.
Misunderstood. Would you care for me to explain anything?
Oh, do I gotta go through this? I guess I could go through it once. Peace is a lie. There is only passion? Oh, you're just denying the Jedi code right away
the
there.
The Jedi would have you believe that peace is a desirable goal. That peace of the spirit is the way the Force is mastered. That a lack of conflict betters man. We know different. It is our passion, our hate, and our desire that fuels the Force. It is conflict that improves the lot of civilization and single being both. Conflict forces one to better oneself. It forces change, growth, adaption, evolution, or death. These are not our laws, but the universe's. Without conflict, you have only stagnation.
How many people are agreeing with the Sith? They make the Sith thing really stand out in this game, if you haven't noticed. And no wonder people go for being a Sith on this game. And of course, I showed you another reason why, which is when you get like the chain lightning and the drain and plague, you just like you cycle through them and it's just like bloop bloop bloop, and it's just like you instantly win. You're always full health, and three or four enemies die at once, not one at a time. It's just like there's no comparison.
What fuels your power with the Force but your passion? The stronger, darker emotions, anger, hatred, fear. These passions empower us.
What about love?
Love is more dangerous than all those things. Love leads to anger and hatred more often than not, but it also leads to mercy, which is far worse. That, however, is a lesson for another time.
Do you love me? I'm your favorite. No, she doesn't love me. She totally wants to use my awesome powers for her gain. And then she'll probably try to turn on me and kill me so that no one can stand in her way. That's exactly what a Sith would think like. These seem like awfully negative passions. The Jedi say the opposite. How can both be right?
The Force gives us all power, even the Jedi. It is our mastery of our passion that gives us the strength they lack.
You've never fought in Yoda, haven't you? You'd get your butt kicked by him. What about love again? These seem like awfully negative passions.
Negative? Compared to what? What keeps even the most rudimentary creature alive? Fear to run. Anger to fight. Without it, a creature would most surely die.
We're not creatures, though. Are you saying we aren't anything more than thank you, rudimentary creature. A rudimentary creature, or...
We are far more than them, perhaps. But in some ways, we are little different. To think us creatures beyond the need of simple passions is a delusion.
All right, I see.
It is our goal to be stronger, to achieve our potential and not rest upon our laurels. We are the seekers, not the shepherds.
Right, so the Jedi... I don't know, I still like the Jedi thing. I did strength. Through strength I gained power.
The yeah. Stronger you become in the Force, the more power you will achieve. But always must you fight for your power. Without strife, your victory has no meaning. Without strife, you do not advance. Without strife, there is only stagnation.
Did I do this? Through power... I gain victory.
How many sorts of victories can you imagine? Peaceful
all
victory.
All of them.
Victory by sacrifice, a truce, an achievement. Unless the victory is achieved by demonstrating that your power is superior, it is only an illusion, temporary at best. We seek more.
Power and then chains. Or victory and chains. Yeah, it's victory then chains. Through victory, my chains are broken.
This has been argued over, and often. The chains represent our restrictions, both those placed upon us and those we place upon ourselves. Ultimately, the goal of any Sith is to free herself from such restrictions. In a way, it is so we may do whatever we wish, but it is much more than that. One who has freed themselves from all restrictions has reached perfection, their potential fulfilled. Perfect strength, perfect power, perfect destiny. Imagine it. That is our ideal, at any rate. It is said in Sith legend that the Sithari, the perfect being, will one day lead us. But perhaps that is just a legend.
First of all, she's talking exactly like a Sith. She said herself. She said, as a her, not as in everyone else, us or them, her, she, what she's talking, anyway, I caught that, the Sithari. That sounds, you don't think the Sithari can exist?
I wonder what that being would be like.
It's
me.
Legends
say the Sithari will destroy us and make us stronger than ever. But perhaps that is just a legend. Perfection is a goal, I think, rather than a state of being. The Jedi would argue that, no doubt.
Well, I kind of like the Jedi more then. Fine. Anyway, the Force shall free me.
The Force is our servant and our master, our teacher and our companion, a weapon and a tool. Know it, and you know the universe. Master it, and you master the universe. Strive for perfection, and the Force shall reward you.
Wow, okay, I think I get it.
I am not surprised. The Force is strong with you. Master it, and it shall serve you well.
How do I get more prestige?
You must impress Master Uthar. Go to him with news of your deeds, or artifacts you have discovered. The code of the Sith is the easiest way to start.
Oh, of course. I'm going to give that to him right away.
I told you all that you need to know of it already. There are a group of students who refused an order by Master Uthar to execute a group of civilians in the colony. Uthar declared that they were to be executed themselves, but the students escaped and fled before the order could be carried out. We are certain that they have not left Korriban. No doubt they have not gotten far and are simply in hiding. We just do not know where exactly. If you were to locate them and carry out Uthar's order, I am sure he would be most appreciative.
Shall I go on? Yes, go on.
I would suggest you talk to the other prospective Sith and find one you can gain an advantage with. I believe Lasho would be an excellent choice. She is too trusting. I have little doubt you could talk her into letting you help her somehow. Just make sure it is you who gains the advantage, not her. Be ruthless if you must. That is the only thing that will impress Uthar. The only other idea I can suggest to you is that you head into the Valley of the Dark Lords on the surface. There are ancient ruins there which can be explored. It's possible you might find some artifacts or information in them which would please Uthar. It's difficult to say for certain.
All right, would I play it as a Sith? Did I kill everyone in here? Or because I remember one time that everyone died, like there was no one, it was just me. I walked in and be like, what's up? Was I a Jedi and I did that, or was I Sith and I just killed everyone? I can't remember. I want to know more about these runes on the surface.
I have been involved in the work there over the last couple of years, but not often. Most of the excavating is left to the students. What did you wish to know?
Is there any way? No, I already know that. Why is the Sith so interested in these
runes?
We could
learn much about the history of the ancient Sith, why they were on Korriban, and why they left. Perhaps we could learn more about the origin of the Force itself. With that knowledge could come great power.
So they just... I've heard enough. I know all about the Naga Shadow. Sado, not Shadow.
As you wish.
Tell me about yourself.
About myself. I'm originally from Slaheron, if you must know. I was a slave to a cruel master, Omish the Hutt. I'm sure you don't need to know more.
No, I don't want to know that. Omish the Hutt. Okay, well, I'll be going.
You have had an excellent start. Go, gain more prestige.
Ding. Oh, 1,000 experience. What? That's crazy. Can I steal from... Not steal, borrow. Without the intention to return these things to her. I can't remember if that's the way or if this is the way. Ah, oh, darn it. I'm just going to go this way and find out. Go up. Of course it's up. Okay, so I'm 180 around. We're going to go to the back and then work my way back in. Because I always go the wrong way. And if I run into... Uthar... I hacked into his room once. Now, I know Carth.
Ready. On it.
There. Impossible. I know, yes. His skill's too low. I hacked into his room once and got a whole bunch of his stuff. I kind of almost wanted to sort of do that. And if I hit the map, that's where I came from. This is my spot, my bedroom. Okay, which is that way. And I'm going this way because it's in the shape of like a weird key thing. I think. Yeah, it is. Oh, no. Okay, and who else? Carth, yes. Can you
ready.
Hack into this for me?
On it. Damn.
Oh, sure. Okay. I tried to, like, you know, use skills and stuff. I guess I'm gonna... Heavy repeating blaster, what? Sith sniper rifle. I want to try all those out. Anyway, I gotta save before I talk to these people. Because I know my persuasion sucks. And all I'm going to do is aim them. Kill Alguin. Kill Alguin? What? Anyway, I don't remember anyone name being that. Save here. I'm totally going to get the most prestige. I'm going to just murder everyone. Fight for the light side and get all the points. Okay, there you go. Oh, talk.
Hello. I don't remember seeing you here before. My name is Kel. Kel Alguin.
Is something wrong?
Nothing.
Are you sure?
Yes. My master always says I'm too trusting, too willing to show weakness. You're a Sith, so I really shouldn't. You know.
But I'm not a Sith yet. I can't persuade you to tell me. Do you know? I'm not a Sith yet.
Oh, I know that. I mean, you aren't yet, but you intend to be. I mean, you're just like everyone else here.
And you're not?
Well, I didn't mean it like that.
Well, how did you mean it then?
I shouldn't trust you. I can't trust you. Can I?
Oh, darn it. But okay, sure you can. You want to trust me.
I just don't feel I belong here.
It worked.
Maybe I did at first, but now I don't know. I have so many doubts.
My hand swooshed. That means I used my Jedi powers. If it doesn't feel right, then perhaps you don't belong here.
But where would I go then? What would I do?
Have you thought about the Jedi?
I don't know. I never really thought about it. Maybe I should seek it out. Give it a try. Thank you. Thank you so much.
See ya. Light side points. Thank you. Excellent. I got someone on our side. Oh, my mom was glowing. Oh, I practically am glowing. You know what? I think that's as high as the light side goes. Because now I have a beam of light behind me. Yep, I think I've made it to the maximum rank of light side points. Because you can't glow any more than that. So if the Sith is taking me in now, well, it's their fault. That was awesome. We got somebody on our side. All right, cool. Now I go this way. And then I go left because I think right leads me to... Darn it, LaShao. Still going this way. Mikael. Now I'll talk to you in a bit. You... Anyone remember Dustal Onassi? As in Carth Onassi? We finally made it here. All right, I hope this works. Please work. Let's save Carth's son before this episode ends. That's who I was looking for. I thought she was also on this side. The trust is a lie, and you all know it, and you didn't tell me it was a lie.
You take a wrong turn somewhere.
Dustal, is that you?
Oh, lovely. It's Father. Figures you'd show up after all this time. How did you manage to get inside the academy?
Through the front doors. The same way you did, I bet. No. Through the front doors. Does it matter we're here?
Maybe it doesn't matter. Or maybe Master Uthar would be interested in knowing just what kind of company he has present here. Just why are you here, Father? Not for me, I hope. Couldn't you have gotten yourself blown up on some ship and spared us this reunion?
Dustal, what are you talking about? I thought you were dead.
Too bad you didn't still think that. Or did you really think I'd be happy to see you? Look, everyone, it's Father, come to rescue me at long last. Sure, he may have left Mother and I to die on Telos, but that doesn't matter.
No, I didn't abandon you. The task force is arrived too late. Telos was in ruins, and your mother... I held her while... But I looked for you. I swear I looked everywhere.
Ah, save it. You abandoned us long before. We were alone all during the wars, and even once you came back, you still didn't stay.
I didn't have a choice. I was needed at...
Yeah? Well, you were needed at home, too. You were needed when the bombing started, and I got captured. You know what? It doesn't matter. Not anymore. I have a new family now, a family that cares about me. I don't need you.
The Sith? You can't mean that. No, the Sith killed your mother. The Sith destroyed Telos.
So? You're the soldier, father. How many mothers have you killed?
No, you've been brainwashed. The son I knew would never...
You never knew me. You weren't even there to know me. So don't presume to tell me what I would or wouldn't do.
I don't know what's been done to you, but you are coming with me out of here now.
Touch me, old man, and I'll kill you. Get out! Get out of here before I tell the Sith that you're here.
Whoa! Okay. I've only done this... This will be my second time doing this. Because I've had Carth... And I... Did I... No, I didn't do this last time with the live stream. This is like my second time doing this. Wow, I don't remember being so spunky? Spunky. Sure. That's what I'll go with this time. Calm down, Dustal. Carth is only trying to protect you. Looks like your boy's all grown up, Carth. That's... You don't want to do that, Dustal. Trust me. Let it go, Carth. This is... No, we're gonna save him. We must... Calm down, Dustal. Carth is trying to protect you.
I don't need his protection. Not anymore. The Sith give me everything I need.
You can't mean that. The Sith are... They're evil. They're the dark side. They took me away from you and your mother. They're what took you from me.
No. They are not evil. They're not. The dark side is superior. And you were at war long before they came along.
The Sith war to conquer, to rule the helpless. I went to war for you, Dustal, for your freedom, your future.
I don't believe you.
If I failed you, son, then it's my failure. Please don't add to it by becoming part of something evil.
Prove it. Prove that the Sith are so evil, and I'll think about it.
Oh, okay, we can do that. I can probably do that. Does anyone got this vibe from the movie, the new movies that are out for the Star Wars? You know, so-and-so's son is on the Sith side, and you know who is practically on the light side. Anyway, it's got that same kind of thing again. Come with us then, and we'll show you. How can we prove something like that? This is pointless. Come with us, and we'll show you.
I'm not gonna follow you around. Forget it. If you're caught, they'll just think I was betraying them. I'll stay right here. I won't tell anyone you're here. For now, you find some proof, and you bring it to me. If I hear you asking questions about me, or doing a single thing to jeopardize my position in the Sith, I swear I'll tell everyone what you're up to. You got that, Father? You prove what you're saying is true. I'm not going anywhere otherwise.
I got it, Dustal. I'll be back. I swear it.
Boom. What do we do? What I want, yes, this is what I want. Finding Dustal. Karn's son has been found, but the reunion was not exactly what he hoped. Exactly. Dustal does not believe anything Carth has to say on the true nature of his new family. Carth is desperate to find some kind of proof that of the Academy that the Sith are evil and bring it to Dustal to open his eyes. That is not giving me any... Carth!
What do you need?
Talk!
No, just to find something. Anything that will convince Dustal that we're telling the truth. Must be something in the Academy that we can bring to him. Something that would show him what the Sith really are.
Great. That we're gonna have to find everything. Michelle, whatever your name is, you couldn't still be called Michelle. I think I called you that last time too, but it just fits you too well. People screaming in the background, I hear that. Not in my house or at your house in the game. We're in the Sith Academy, of
it's
course.
It's a bad year to try and become a Sith, you know. I've got it all wrapped up.
I remember you, Michelle, right?
That's right. You might as well just go home, you know. There can only be one Sith this year, and that's me.
Is it? Oh, good. Nice to meet you, Seth Michelle. Whatever. I'm the one who's going
to
make it.
Well, you're off to a super start. You've got no more prestige than I do at the moment. Thing is, I know how to get some.
You lie. You're lying, I can tell.
Think what you like. Just remember, only one of us gets to become a Sith.
Yes, me. I know.
You're hanging
talk.
Around still. Don't yep. you have your own plans?
Nope.
Not that they'll help you. I'm in for
sure,
they will. You know.
Oh, me. What makes you so
you
sure?
I would tell you?
Yep.
My brain started dribbling out of my nose or something.
If I say yes, would you... would persuade.
But what would be the point in that? See you around, chump.
Darn it. No, you're
hanging
not.
Around.
No, you're not. Makes you so sure. Maybe we can trade information.
There's nothing you know that I could. You hanging around?
Punk?
You think I'm...
It would be an improvement.
Funny. Say that after I'm a full Sith, and I'll ground your face into the dirt just for fun.
I'm sorry, I didn't see that the first time. His brain drooping out of his nose. That would be an improvement. Oh my goodness, that is hilarious. I got my own. No, tell me. Hint. Oh, I can't get it out of him. Whatever. I'm going to find everything anyway. So I guess what I'm not getting is the journal entry to let me know that it's there. I'm going to still find it without the journal entry. Shardan. That's a lot of A's. Oh, okay. I thought it was S-H-A-A-R-D-A-A-N, but it's not. That's normal about an A. Amount of A's.
If it isn't the freak from the colony. Hello, freak.
What? Get lost, nerve herder. What? You want to make an issue out of it? Who are you?
Shardan's the name. Don't forget it. You'll have me to thank when you get kicked out of here.
What? You want to make an issue out of it? Get lost. You want
to
make an issue?
The dueling room. I've got better things to do than give you a fair fight. You can count on me later, though. My lightsaber has your name on it.
You have my name on your lightsaber? Oh my goodness, I'm so famous and popular. Wow. I mixed both of those words together. Awesome.
I remember you from the colony. I can't believe you actually made it into the academy.
I can't believe you still talk to me after I gave you attitude, sassitude. I remember you. I challenge you to a duel.
Fine. You run along and get ready while I go gain some prestige. Idiot.
Oh, that did not go well.
I remember you from the colony.
Right. Who are
My
you?
My name is Lasho. Remember it.
Lasho.
For I'll be the one who earns the prestige to move on. You'll have to be satisfied with next year, I suppose.
I'm trying to become a Sith.
Figure that out, did you?
Yeah,
it
just
so happens
to...
that I have a surefire way of pulling ahead in this little contest of ours. You don't really have a chance.
Surefire way to speed things up. Anyway, perhaps we could work together. Raise eyebrow and click.
I suppose I could use some help. The artifact I know of certainly won't be easy to take. But why should I work with you?
I've always wanted to work with a beautiful woman. Because together we will be unbeatable. Ooh, that sounds nice. Because you want... No, unbeatableness.
Forget it.
Darn it! I'm trying again. This will work. Persuade. Help.
You? Help me get it? I don't know.
It worked!
I suppose I could use some help. The artifact I know of certainly won't be easy to take. But why should I work with you?
Darn it! I just persuaded and made it in, and now I gotta do it again because we're unbeatable. Darn it! I will find my own way, I guess. This is impossible. I cannot persuade anyone. I guess it's really only... They just give me... they'll meet me in front of the place, and we'll go together, and I get the and I kill them, and then blah blah blah. It's the same thing over and over, except I don't have that journal entry to prove it. I'm gonna do a loop because why not? Because it's near the end. Where is this taking me? Nowheres. Okay. And then this will take me, and that will take me. Ooh, they got names. I may talk to them in the next episode. Yeah, alright, let's go right here. In the next episode, I am going to drop off my skills of the Sith. What is it called? The Sith, whatever, enchantment thing to him. The passion, strength, power, victory, my chains are broken line. And then I will gain some prestige, very little bit, and then I will do what I can do without having the know-how of doing it based on this game. Basically, it's the same thing. I'm still going to each of the catacombs and getting what's down there without the journal entry. I'll probably run into them still, I think. I think it works that way. It works that way. But I'll be doing it the good side, so I'll be freeing the people and letting them escape and pretending that I killed them and doing the thing with the robot, except getting in there and being able to talk to him. And then... And then letting him escape as well. I can't remember. There's a whole bunch of things. Anyway, we're gonna trick the Sith by doing all good and making them think I'm doing bad. Yeah, that's how this is gonna go down. Instead of me, I think I don't know if I kill everyone or not though. Still, I can't remember how I did it. Where I was the only one at the end of the trial. Either way, it's gonna be interesting to see how this goes. So. Thanks everybody for showing up and watching, and seriously, if you like what I'm doing, hit those buttons, you know what to do by now, and I will see you all in the next episode. Take care.